This segment brought to you by Bob Schwartz Financial. Values, commitment, transparency.
Listed on the National Register of Historic Places, the Brown Grand Theater is a majestic opera house in Concordia, Kansas. Built in 1907, the theater has been through a multitude of changes through the years, but has stayed in constant operation and is still providing quality entertainment to the community today. Jason Grogan, director, tells us about the history of the Brown Grand Theater.
Yeah, it was actually construction began in 1905 and was completed in 1907. The opening night was September 17th, 1907, with the Vanderbilt Cup as their first show. Mm-hmm. That course was based on the Vanderbilt family from the East Coast. They had an annual boat race, but the play had changed it over to be a car race because, mm-hmm. you know, cars were an up-and-coming thing and the races were starting. And so 1,000 people in attendance on opening night. It was also the first night that our founder, Napoleon Bonaparte Brown, stepped foot in here. Mm-hmm. He gave the kids, his son Earl and daughter-in-law Gertrude, basically $40,000 to have this place built. And he was known to sit on his front porch, which his house is about four blocks down the street and kind of up on the hill, so mm-hmm. he could see the progress of the building as it went up. And mm-hmm. so he didn't step in here until opening night. And then, of course, a lot of people love to come see our what's called the Napoleon Curtain. And this was a hand-painted curtain that was a gift from Earl to Dad for having them build the place. Mm-hmm. And yeah. So very neat. One of the unique features about the Vanderbilt Cup at that time was that it was using modern technology to actually make it look like moving backgrounds and cars racing across the stage. They had them set up on a pulley and treadmill-like system, mm-hmm. and so it really gave the audience the feel of cars racing by on stage.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
So basically, it operated as a opera house and performance theater until around 1924. When, of course, silent movies were really becoming popular. And so it was sold to a film company, which turned it into a movie theater. Mm-hmm. And it operated from 1924 to 1977 as a movie theater. And then the town folks decided, well, let's take it back to its original glory the best we could. And mm-hmm. so they started doing a fundraiser. They got some grants and were able to then start the restoration process, and was then completed in 1980. And so they had a week-long of festivities, mm-hmm. with the September 17th, 1980 being the grand reopening.
Yeah.
And a couple ladies in attendance that night were treated like royalty because they were here at the original opening in mm-hmm. 1907, and again on the grand reopening in 1980.
That is amazing. It really
is.
Yeah,
pretty neat story. You know, even when it was a movie theater, they said that the stage was plenty big, that they still had live boxing matches, wrestling matches, political campaigns, all kinds of different things. And so
it is wild to think about all the different variety of activities that have taken place in that theater since it opened. It really is. The Brown Grand Theater has a full schedule of events coming up, and you can view that on their website, browngrand.org. Tours can also be scheduled by calling the theater during business hours. Plan a visit soon and enjoy this wonderful piece of Kansas history.
I'm Bob Schwartz, and I've devoted the last 43 years to helping Kansans reach their retirement goals and to protect the family farm. At Bob Schwartz Financial, we believe everyone should be able to live the retirement they've always dreamed of. Our team of professionals can help you create an efficient strategy using a variety of investment vehicles to help you address your financial needs and your concerns. Bob Schwartz Financial, values, commitment, and transparency.